In New Delhi, India and Japan have agreed to collaborate closely in defense production, including a dual-use technologies, as the two countries resolve to ramp up overall military engagement under the bilateral special strategic framework. Defense Minister Arun Jaitley and his Japanese counterpart Itsunori Onodera yesterday held wide-ranging talks as a part of India-Japan annual defense ministerial dialogue in Tokyo, during which the issues relating to the US two amphibious aircraft also figured, as the joint press statement said. The decision by India and Japan to boost defense ties comes aimed at escalating the tension in the region in the wake of nuclear tests by North Korea and China's growing assertiveness in the South China Sea. The two sides also agreed to commence the technical discussions for research collaboration in the areas of unmanned ground vehicles and robotics. India plans to buy the US 2 Shinmayava aircraft from Japan for its navy. The last year, China had reacted angrily to the reports that Japan plans to sell weapons to India at cheaper price, saying that such a move is disgraceful. The two sides also agreed to ramp up counter-terror cooperations, besides deepening engagement among navies, air force, and the ground force of the two countries. Ministers exchanged views and ideas with the aim to further strengthen the defense and the security cooperation under the framework of Japan-India's Special Strategic and Global Partnership, a statement said last week. The statement said, Jaitley and Onodera deliberated on the current security situations in the Indo-Pacific region and condemned in the strongest terms North Korea's latest nuclear test and called upon the country to cease such actions which adversely impacts peace and stability of the region and in the peninsula. Reviewing bilateral defense ties, they commanded the progress made in discussions to identify specific areas of collaboration in the field of defense equipment and technology cooperations for the production of various military platforms. They noted the effort made by both countries regarding the cooperation of US two amphibious aircraft, said in a statement last week. The minister endorsed the importance of enhancing the interaction between the governments and defense industries of two countries to encourage collaboration, including for the defense and the dual use of technologies. In the meeting, Jaitley briefed about India's policies reforms in the defense manufacturing sector, saying the country offers huge opportunities for foreign industries to play an active role. Seeking to further intensify the naval cooperations, Onodera expressed his intentions to have a state-of-the-art Japanese assets, including the P-1 maritime patrol aircraft, to participate in next year's trilateral Malabar naval exercise, which also involves US Navy. The two sides will consider inclusion of anti-submarine warfare training to expand the cooperation. In addition, the ministers agreed to pursue exchanges and training by ASW Aviation's units such as P-3C, a statement said last week. The P-3C is an anti-submarine and maritime surveillance aircraft. Japanese side proposed to invite Indian Navy personnel to mine countermeasures training held by it. Jaitley attended the dialogue with Japan as the defense minister, though Nirmala Sitharaman was given the defense portfolio in the cabinet reshuffle on Sunday. Last week, Jaitley had said there were logistical constraints for her to attend the dialogue. At the talks, the two sides have welcomed the constructive engagement between the Japanese Acquisition Technology and Logistics Agency ATLA and India's Defence Research and Development Organization DRDO. The defence and security cooperation between India and Japan is on an upswing, and both countries are exploring ways to further deepen it. Prime Minister of India and Mr. Narendra Modi has visited Japan in November last year, during which both sides had decided to ramp up the bilateral defense and security cooperation. In New Delhi, the expert body FAEO today said there is a huge potential to increase the bilateral trade between India and Singapore to $25 billion by 2019 to 2020. India's export to Singapore grew by 23% last fiscal year, though the overall export expanded by only 4%. However, the bilateral trade with Singapore is only 2.52% of India's overall trade. The Federation of Indian Export Organization FAEO President Ganesh Gupta said in a statement, "We can easily reach $25 billion of trade with Singapore by 2020, from the current level of $17 billion. The FAEO is there in Singapore to participate in the Singapore International Expo. Gupta said the expo is providing an opportunity to MSME to showcase the wide range of quality products to high demanding customers in Singapore. Participants from 89 companies are representing their products from the sectors including apparels, gems and jewelries, furniture, handicrafts and textiles. So what do you think of India and Japan becoming officially the allies in defense deals and defense manufacturing sector? And Indo-Singapore trade may reach $25 billion by 2020? What's your thoughts? Post your comments below, and if you like this video, please give a thumbs up and follow us on social networks and subscribe to our channel. And thanks for watching. This is WC Daily. Think big, think different. Bye.